Dans cette séquence, je vais montrer trois phénomènes.
In this session, I'll show you three phenomena which are quite characteristic of the era we are living in. First, the fact that economic growth is linked to a huge growth in consumption of raw materials. Second, that this is an exponential growth, and this exponential growth has significant consequences on long-term management of raw materials. For non-renewable materials, it's particularly interesting because we know about the flows. An iron atom is the one we had a century ago and the one we'll have in a century. And raw materials are what's available and what was available on the Earth crust, which is easier than with renewable raw materials, in which you have many exchanges between different cycles. So here, it becomes an exact science, and that's pretty easier to manage. So let's look at iron and steel. Iron is the emblematic material for the Industrial Revolution. And if we take a look at the black graph here, the evolution in global steel production since the beginning of the 20th century, and beyond year 2000, we see that the graph is getting closer to the white graph, which is an exponential growth at a growth rate of 3.5% per annum. So we're getting close, except in just the post-World War II period. And in the 70s, 80s, we are back to the exponential graph. So we have this exponential profile, which we also have for other raw materials, such as copper, etc., not with the same trend over a century, but with a nice exponential shape over 30, 40 years. So we can think that the growth in raw material consumption follows an exponential trend. Now, if we take a look at the impact of this exponential growth on the life of resources, we see very interesting things indeed. Resources are not reserves. Resources, if we look at the way they are defined by the American Geology Agency, these are the deposits which are identified and which will be operational in economically viable conditions today or later. So we're not talking about known or suspected deposits, and which we usually refer to when we talk about oil deposits, and which can be operated in the current circumstances, and that changes as the price of materials increases or fluctuates, because when the price becomes higher, then some resources are more interesting to operate. But these are not included because they were already included in as a reserve because they've been known for a century or more. Now, looking at things for different materials, if we take a look at the second column to the left on this chart, you see that we have resources for various materials, various metals, which are perfectly emblematic: lithium, chromium, iron. Lithium, which is increasingly used for batteries at the moment, and for each of these metals, we looked at the resources as assessed by the U.S. Geology Survey, and we looked at consumption in 2008. If you look at consumption versus production, we have a certain number of years in reserves, and you see that it ranges from 2 to 5 centuries. So quite reassuringly, at the current rhythm, we have far less. For resources, we have 2 to 5 centuries of resources ahead of us, so we've got time to adapt. The problem is, if you look at percentage, what you see is the percentage of average growth between 1998 and 2008, just before the economic crisis. And you see that the annual growth in consumption varies from 2.8 to 7%. So dividing resources by the production of 2008 makes absolutely no sense. Between 1998 and 2008, global production of iron ore has doubled. So if we had taken the same rationale in 1998, it would have made no sense. So what we need to do is to project not just a constant growth in these raw materials, because we've never had a constant production of these materials, but we need to understand consumption growth. And there are many scenarios we can't read in a crystal ball, so we have to make assumptions. And to the right, you have three assumptions. The central assumption in gray for each of the material, that's where future consumption would increase by 3.5% per year, as was the case in the 20th century. So the bar chart shows from 2000 the date at which resources, as assessed by the U.S. Geological Survey, would be totally used up if, based on the 2008 consumption level, we were to consume 3.5% more each year. The black scenario is business as usual. So we take the growth rate for the decade 1998-2008, and we do the same for the future, as it's quite high for most raw materials. You see that in many cases, resources last less, because as we are going to increase, we are going to consume the available resource much faster. And the more optimistic scenario, we assume that growth is going to slow down and that we move to 2% growth in terms of consumption growth for each raw material, and therefore they last more. But as compared to a standard equal consumption, the number of years is 45 to 120 years, depending on the raw material. So by and large, known resources after a couple of centuries of active geological investigations, all this comes to an end at the end of this century. So all the economy based on raw material, if we had continued consuming at a constant rate, everything is focused on this century. And in the following century, this will have even more significant impacts on resources that we've not yet identified. So the end of this diagram is not the end of raw materials. We've not exhausted all resources. There is plenty of iron ore on the planet. That's the major material in the terrestrial crust. But the problem is that it's present at densities and in places that makes it very difficult to mine, and the cost in terms of economic and environmental costs would be much higher than they are today. If we produce five times less iron today, in the future as we do today, it means that we will have to dig up more soil to get iron, and this will have an impact on soils, on energy, on waters. So of course all this will be mitigated by technology, but still this is not yet the end of raw material, but it's a new economic paradigm that we don't know yet and that will require a new economy by the end of this century.